Previously on Live Shot.
And who are you?
Helen Forbes, the new general manager.
I'm fired.
What a cold, soulless bitch.
The National Rifle Association.
The focus group used words like reliable, fruitful.
He stays.
Are you planning on making changes in my department? Because if you are.
We'll talk.
Oh, damn. I got a book. It's my night to watch the baby. Ramona, somebody got popped.
Don't worry. Go back to sleep.
Harry! Do not say anything that is not in the script. Not a sentence, not a word, not a syllable.
I think my agent will be seeing old Alec before he knows what's hit him.
And I want a company car.
Mm-hmm. You know, Bill Kramer over at Channel 6 got a Lincoln Town Car.
Really? Did you get it for
him? No, I'm not his agent.
Well, can you get it for me?
Bill Kramer is a 38-year-old anchor with dimples. What do you want from me?
Okay, what do I want? I want a 10% increase in all wages and benefits across the board.
Now you're being realistic.
I want my name 10% larger than Sherry's in all paid advertising. I want complete approval of all staff hiring and firing. And what is it that I ask for every 2 years and never get?
Harry.
We have a new GM.
Helen Forbes? She thinks with her penis, if you get my meaning. Forget it. She's never going to let you own the Beacon of Truth, ever.
Why not?
Because if you own it, you can market it. Beacon of Truth keychains, Beacon of Truth t-shirts, Beacon of Truth underwear.
Exactly.
Franklin Delano Roosevelt High Rockets warm up for the final game of the season.
The mood here in the house is optimistic. But then again, the mood is always optimistic because the Rockets have been state champions since 1984. 82. Well, who's going to argue with them? Remarkably, every graduating Rocket has gone on to receive a scholarship at a top university.
Now get the
Ohio
schools,
State,
right.
The University of Michigan, Notre Dame, Penn State, Caltech.
Don't forget USC.
And let's not forget USC.
Yes, my alma mater. You went to college?
Contract renewal time again, Harry?
Look at this. Is this really noticeable?
Pimple is always noticeable.
They say I'm out of touch with the youth market.
You've been trying to squeeze it?
15 seconds. Makeup? Makeup! That in a world filled with so many temptations for teenagers these days, it's nice
to see that there are still some upstanding young men who are following the footsteps of a rich football
player. You don't know what these animals
are. Tommy, get rid of her.
You don't know what these
rich
football players are.
Ma'am, excuse me.
They raped my daughter!
Ma'am,
four of them!
Report.
Get away from me! Get away from you! You got a freighter view!
Oh.
They raped
Kill it.
My daughter!
Four Kill it! Kill it!
Hugh Harry!
Thanks, Lou. There you have it. Teenagers who really know how to score.
Fine example for other young men.
Sharon? Where was I? Yeah. 15% bump across the board, including a 15% increase in the size of Harry's name in all ads and promotions, 6 weeks paid vacation, and use of the phrase, the Beacon of Truth. Do I take that to mean Harry is free to entertain other offers?
We'll get back to you.
And there you have it, Sherry. Teenagers really know how to sport.
Buddy, I'm gonna... Come on, head on out.
No, come on. It's baby home, all right?
No. Come on, it's late.
Well, what do you got to rush on for? You're young, you're single.
What are you?
I'm young.
And you're soon to be single.
Yeah.
The woman has radar. No. She doesn't have radar. Look.
Huh?
Yeah, well, it's almost 11 o'clock at night. You know, husband should be at home with his wife and not out here having a good time with all these fun people.
What are you, Ramona's agent?
You gonna call him?
You give me one good reason why I shouldn't hang up on you.
Because it's me, Eddie.
Eddie, where is Tommy?
It's almost 11 o'clock.
Well, but see, he wanted me to call you. And because he couldn't make it to call you, and
because he's busy setting up the live shot for the 11th.
You know, he just wanted me to call because you did the beeper thing, and he just wanted me to make sure that, you know, that you were fine.
And if there was, you know, an emergency, God forbid, if that happened, that, you know, that he would drop everything. He would drop the cable. He would drop the sun gun.
Are you just about done?
Just about. Remember, you got 2 feet,
right?
And you're going to walk.
Okay. Oh, the homestead. Someday, Eddie, all this is going to be yours.
Shh. Hey, buddy, you want me to come in with you?
What?
And she won't yell at you if I'm there, you know?
No, shh. Yeah, she will.
Yeah, she will.
I know. I'm trying to get her to sleep. Don't slam the door. The baby's sleeping. Turn down TV, Tommy. The baby's sleeping. Don't breathe. The baby's sleeping. Hey, hey.
I just got her quiet.
Come on, we gotta go. You're gonna be late for school.
Did you want any for my project?
Yes, I did. That's a lot of stuff, huh?
I almost kept an art drawing.
You did? Well, we're gonna have to start one. What's your project? Shoelace.
A diorama. You take a box and you make a 3D scene in it. We have to do one of a job world we admire.
Really? Well, newsroom's gonna be a little tough to do in clay.
I'm not doing that. I'm doing a race car driver.
Oh. And the front runner in the gubernatorial race, County Commissioner Dennis Mosby, denies he knew his housekeeper was an undocumented alien.
She laughed.
Yep.
She actually laughed?
Like a hyena.
Well, yeah, but, maybe she was thinking about something else.
No. I think it was just a little bit of gamesmanship. I think she's playing poker. Let's look at what we're after and see what we're willing to give up.
Look at this. They're grooming Sandoval to be my replacement.
Nonsense.
Look at him, sitting on his stool.
Now, no one can replace the beacon.
What, kidding? You don't have to worry about truth when you got that Latin thing going for you.
Forget him, he's nothing.
I hate him. I just hate him.
Harry. Harry, relax. A contract is like a marriage. Every so often, they gotta be reminded what a catch you are. Is that a pimple?
Oh, my God.
At noon, we'll have more on that escaped mountain lion. We hope to have a statement from County Commissioner Mosby, and we'll have more on the weekend weather with Dr. Bob. Now, we're taking it to the streets.
Taking it to the streets, yo.
Taking it to the streets, where you speak your mind. Today's topic, our legal system.
Okay, OJ trial. He's innocent. Reason why I say that. They trying to convict my boy on DNA. I'm starting to think DNA stands for that nigga arrested. Because the fact that they got OJ in, they trying to bring in this blood expert and tell me there's a difference between white blood and black blood. I'm saying if there's a difference between white blood and black blood, why am I donating blood?
Ricardo Sandoval.
Well, close. Mitch Merman, World Talent Group. I hear you're quite a comer.
Thanks.
Lunch sometime.
Sometime.
Okay.
Good.
They raped my daughter! Four of them! They raped my daughter! Four of them! Well, 12, watch!
Ah!
Nut bar.
The police report says that she's been fired from her last two jobs due to the inability to perform. And she's also got a pretty lengthy psychiatric history.
Yeah, who doesn't?
We talked to the coach, the parents of three of the boys she's pointing a finger at, the principal, the police chief, nothing. And you ready for this? And I'm not kidding. Two of the boys do volunteer work at a soup kitchen.
This about the crazy lady?
Hey, Lou, come on in. Listen, I've asked Lou to try to get a comment from the daughter. She's one of the cheerleaders.
Really? You got her in any of the coverage?
Let's see. Cheerleaders in any of Santini's coverage. What are the odds?
That's her. She says her mom's nuts. Has been since the divorce a year ago. One time she painted a face on her hand, and she made it talk.
Thank you, Lou.
This looks okay to me.
What do you mean, undamaged?
Well, yeah.
Well, what she doesn't look like is news. Story's dead.
Expensive thing in the menu.
Well, if Hennessy hadn't died, Alex would be long gone and you'd be buying me lunch.
Thank you. Oh, God, it's Harry.
What?
He's gonna end up sitting with us.
This could be your lucky day. Maybe you could stick him with the check.
Oh, wait. He's got a date. Hey, isn't that the Channel 8 news director?
It sure is. Wow, wow.
It will be there by 3.
Thanks.
Oh, here's the outline. Let's go to lunch. I would love to, Liz, but I can't. I just got an appointment to get my nails done. And that leaves me 20 minutes to go pick up a birthday card for What's-His-Name in editing. I have to drop off this skirt to get him, that lamp to get fixed, and then I have to swing by City Hall and maybe sign up for traffic school because I got a speeding ticket. Oh, great. We'll do lunch in about 3 weeks. Alex?
I got my son's lunch.
Do you want to go out? I mean, to lunch?
Well, it's a tough choice.
It looks like you got lots of errands to run here.
Well, not really. It's nothing that can't wait. What?
Listen, I don't want you to think that you have to ask me to lunch just because... because I kissed you, you know?
I know.
Oh, sorry.
Sorry.
You know what?
Dad,
I
know
the great place.
It's going up.
Dwight Brewer for Alex Riddell. Yes? Alex Riddell. Yeah. Hi, you caught me. Go out the door. Dwight Brewer. I'm family attorney for Brian Hall, the quarterback at Franklin Delano Roosevelt.
Yeah, yeah.
Listen, we're a little concerned about a nutcase like that woman leveling such insane charges against minors on the air.
Well, actually, we've decided
I'm sorry,
to...
this is Nancy Lockridge. Nancy produces our 11. Hello.
Hi.
What you saw was called a live shot. And the woman's presence was unexpected, and of course, there's no time to edit it out.
So... I understand.
What is it you were saying you've decided?
We've well... decided that... We're going to take a lot more precautions with live shots.
Well, I'd hate to think what would happen to a young boy's reputation if some viewer were to take her seriously.
Oh, I can't imagine anyone would. Listen, would you excuse us? We're on our way out.
Oh, sure. And thanks.
Why didn't you tell him we weren't going to pursue the story?
You know, the more he talked, the more I asked myself, why does this kid need a lawyer?
Where are we?
no time was I aware that she was illegally here from El Salvador. I thought she was from Guatemala, legally.
Where's she now?
El Salvador,
avoiding what I'm going through right now.
Why did you dismiss her a week before you announced your candidacy?
It had absolutely nothing to do with that. I dismissed Annabella's moral because, quite frankly, she kept mixing the whites with the colors in the wash. If any of you would like to see my pink undershorts, get in line.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. I think the headline here is that this guy wears underwear at all.
Hey, talk about a soundbite.
So, Richard, tell me, why is Harry Chandler Moore leaving three?
What?
Don't be slick. I know he's coming to eight.
What are you talking about?
Come on, Ricardo. It's me here.
Is this you telling me something or fishing for something?
Well, it's at least me telling you that he's been seen dining with our news director. Tell me what you know.
Stu, I just heard that the Beacon may be going over to Channel 8. No, very reliable. You're the agent, but I start negotiations now.
If any of you would like to see my pink undershorts, get in line.
And a line is forming of his political opponents and journalists who are not satisfied with the candidate's look at my shorts defense. And now, Marvin Seaborn with his commentary.
Thank you. Stand-up comics. They're everywhere. They're starring in sitcoms, cable specials in Las Vegas. And America is laughing. But at what cost? That's the problem. Don't be alarmed. That is a whoopee cushion. It used to be in bad taste, but it is a sermon when compared to what is being passed for humor today. Any subject is fodder for material. Nothing is sacred. Nothing. They joke about the president, our country. They tear down our heroes, our institutions, our values, and it's constant. Americans receive an endless stream of this stuff. Is it any wonder our youth wander the streets high on laughter?
There, where he starts running. We want him to prove he's a mountain lion.
Liz, can I see you for a sec?
What's up?
I have a possible story that needs a little background research.
A possible story.
I'm not avoiding going home. I happen to find steakhouse exciting.
Right. Sitting in the back of a van for 8 hours waiting for some housekeeper who's sleeping in her bed in El Salvador. And your wife? She'd cheat on you.
That'd make things a lot easier.
Hey, guys, I need you for about an hour.
No can do. We're setting up for the big illegal housekeeper stakeout.
Just an hour.
Man, any chick around who don't want a piece of my time.
Pick.
Yeah! All I'm saying is you could have at least told me we were coming to see this crazy woman.
We're gonna get in and get out. No big deal, Tommy.
No big deal. Liz, this woman need me in the balls.
Ouch.
Yeah, I got it on paper.
Is this after you called her a chick?
Look at this. This is where that quarterback rapist signed her yearbook. Too good to be forgotten. Now, what do you think that's supposed to mean?
Mrs. Mathias, I'm certain that half the senior class wrote that in their yearbook.
I'm certain they did.
Mrs. Mathias, you say this happened about 3 months ago. Now, why start talking about this now?
Because I just found out about it.
Well, your daughter has denied it to us.
Well, of course she's denied it. She doesn't want anyone to know. She wants life to go on like it was before. She wants everything to be normal. But look at this. Look at this. Grades can't deny it. D's and F's from a B-plus student. And what about this? This hot water bottle and this Kleenex. Katie can't sleep at night, and she cries at the drop of a hat.
Well, she is a teenager.
Okay, what about this? Katie threw this at me the night that she told me everything. This picture will prove that on Saturday night, September 23rd, at a park under a swing set, a place where children play, Katie is no more than a child, really. Under that same swing set where I used to push her, while the rest of them were chanting and urinating off the jungle gym, Brian Hall, that's him right there. Brian Hall. And Two of these other boys and one other forced themselves on my daughter.
Mrs. Mathias, you know, a cracked picture frame isn't exactly proof that this happened, and there are just so many people who say it didn't.
Liars! All of them!
If something this horrible had happened to Katie, do you really believe that your daughter would continue to live with, study with, hang out with, and even cheer for her attackers?
Do you think I could make something like this up?
Must have find out when the luncheon is, if I can get away with a pantsuit, and if there are any nuts in the food. I can't eat nuts.
Hello, may I help you with something?
Hi.
Are you aware of the growing Latino population in Los Angeles?
Pardon?
Lady, we're the minority.
We?
White people.
Why are you telling me this?
I'm Stu Sackheim. I am Ricardo Sandoval's agent.
Uh-huh.
And you know why I'm telling you this.
Alex.
Yeah?
You forgot your box.
My what?
Sean's diorama.
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
Are we having a weird day, or is it just me?
No, it's a weird day. Thank you for the box here.
Hey, Alex, they caught the mountain lion. We got great tape.
Alex?
Oops, they let it out. See ya.
You, Joe, stay.
At least you didn't tell me to roll over.
Word on the street is that Harry's going to Channel 8.
Yeah?
Hmm.
Oh, wait a minute. That doesn't make sense. I don't buy that. Look. They're doing great numbers here.
I knew something was up when I saw him at lunch with Saul Hilburn.
Who?
8's news director.
What? When?
Today.
Where?
La Dome.
Well, we got the who, what, when, and where. All we need now is why.
What did Harry order?
Lobster.
Well, got your why.
No. Who paid?
I don't know.
I want to know if this is more than a rumor, Alex. I don't want to lose him till I know whether or not I want to keep him.
Okay.
He represents the minority.
Ellen?
Harry.
Liz Vega from LA3 Reaction News. Hey, Brian, I'd like to ask you a few questions. Do you know a Katie? Do you know a Katie from your class? Where are you going, Brian?
Something's after Zapter Star Trek Voyager, and it's hot. It's called Live Shot.
Yeah, well, I hope they're slammed so there won't be fixers.
What really goes on before the news goes on?
I'm in the mood to test your mettle.
The new GM is hot to trot, but who will she seduce?
People love seeing guys get hurt.
The anchorman, the news director, someone else.
Let's see how really firm your convictions are.
Find out on Live Shot at a special time next Monday after Voyager on UPN.
24 WCGV-TV, Milwaukee.
Why
am I... If this housekeeper doesn't show by one, just bag the steak out.
Roger.
All I'm saying is that, you know, it just wouldn't hurt to call it.
Yes, dear.
No, I think you're being a real jerk.
You do?
Yeah, well, yeah. I do. And it wouldn't
Why
hurt you.
Why are you suddenly acting like my wife?
Sorry. If she gets on your case, you'll get upset. You know, you'll get upset, you dump on the world.
Since I'm part of the world, I'm thinking...
That concern, she's yours.
I mean, don't joke.
No. Hey. Ramona's you. You're the keys to my house. My life.
All right, I didn't mean to intrude.
How are your keys?
Tell me.
Come on, give me your keys.
Don't.
Where are they?
Tell me, stop.
Come on, man.
Stop.
Give me your keys. Just give me your damn keys.
Stop it! What is going on here? What is this? Tommy.
This is surveillance.
Tommy?
I'm so damn lost, man. I can't see straight. I got no business being married. I got no business being a father.
But you gotta take time to think about this before you, I don't know, get crazy and just walk out.
I'm not walking out. I never walk out on my family. My father walked out on me. I'm staying no matter how miserable I make everybody.
The plan?
Trip. Caltrans announces the completion of a new carpool lane. Oh, I'm awake now.
Hobie, you gotta let me know when you're in the room.
I did.
Uh-huh. How's the missus?
Still dead. Yeah. How's your jock itch?
Hobie, when I asked you to let me know if you ever found anything really interesting in the tragic, I didn't mean my own.
Well, that wasn't interesting. That was conversation.
Oh.
But I did find something interesting.
Now, is this gonna be as good as a Prozac prescription bottle you found in Helen's trash?
Better. For one, I didn't have to dig under an empty Tampax box to get it.
Nice.
Harry left it out in plain sight.
Channel 8. The Smoking Gun.
Sit down on the corner, just a little crime. When I make my money, got to get my dime.
Helen wants you in her office. She's pacing. Alex, when you get a second.
Yeah, hang on. Yes, Alex. Yeah, put him on.
Alex,
don't go away. This is about you.
Alex?
Dwight, how are you?
Not too good, Alex. What's a reporter of yours doing harassing my client?
I'm sorry. What's your client's name?
Brian Hall.
Ah, yes. Harassing? She didn't get near him, Dwight. He ran away. What's that all about?
He's a shy boy, a sensitive boy, but I'm not talking about him.
Why not?
I thought we had an understanding. I thought we agreed that woman was nuts.
I don't recall that.
Be forewarned. My firm is very skilled in libel actions.
Well, I'm sorry, Dwight. We're just checking up on a story, you know, the way the Constitution says we can.
Okay. I get it.
Listen, if you want to follow up on your threat to file a lawsuit, I will mention in my deposition that it was your visit that prompted my curiosity. Yes, Liz, what did you want?
To see if I was pursuing that story any further. I'll let you know what I find.
Don't forget about Helen.
Good morning, Lisa. She's expecting. Helen, how are you?
Look at this.
Oh, wait, this is a personal letter addressed to Harry.
It's not personal, it's business. Look, it has Channel 8's letterhead. Don't be a wuss. Dear Harry, as we expected, you were the perfect player to round out our Channel 8 foursome at Pebble Beach. I hope there's time for a round or two when Charlie's in from New York for your chat.
Charles McMahon, the president of their station group?
That would be my bet.
Wait, he's got to approve all the on-camera talent their station's hired.
I know you'll score. You have a mean swing, Hank. Best Jake Sullivan director of personnel, Hank.
That Channel 8 leech is calling our beacon, Hank.
I need confirmation that Charlie is Charles McMahon and that he's coming into town.
Absolutely.
And without them knowing, I don't want them making an offer Harry can't refuse. Which would be any offer.
This is Reaction News at 5 with Sherry Beck.
Good evening from Channel 3 Reaction News. Before I get to today's lead story, I would just like to inform our viewers that Harry Chandler Moore, the beacon of truth, has left Channel 3 for another anchor position, and our entire newsroom wishes him well. I will continue as news anchor with absolutely no need for a co-anchor because I am just so damn good at this.
Yeah, Sherry. Sherry.
I'm listening. Tell me again about Harry's offer.
Sure. Yeah, you know, for a second there, I thought I'd lost you.
Oh, you have no idea.
Hi, I'm Cindy Wilner with Hyatt Corporate Sales. I'd like to offer you at Channel 8 a special corporate rate for all your visiting executives. Oh, what hotel do you use? Really? Well, thanks for listening. Alex!
Excuse me. Are you from FDR High?
Yeah. Are you that reporter?
Yeah. What are you doing back here?
They wouldn't let me in the front lobby.
Is there a game today?
Oh, there was a pep rally at lunch. You know, you look a lot thinner in person.
Well, that's TV for you. It adds about 10 pounds.
Oh. Well, it wouldn't hurt Katie. She hardly eats. She's always got a stomach ache or something.
Tina, is there anything you want to tell me?
Katie told me that you talked to her mom.
Yes.
I told Katie, please say something to somebody, but she said that she's only got 5 months till graduation, let it alone, but I told her she wouldn't graduate with all the days she's missing with her stomach aches and her headaches, but she said they'd go away, that she was safe, you know? You can't get points for screwing somebody twice.
They're the...
Brian was always pushing Katie for sex. But when they stopped in the park, Katie thought maybe they'd make out, but it wouldn't go any further because there were all these other guys around.
Have any of them forced themselves on you?
No. Not forced, like you mean. The time it happened, I went along with it. I mean, he was on the team. Brian wanted Katie because she was worth 2 points because she was a virgin. Of course, then she was only worth 1 point for all the other guys.
Does anyone else besides you know about this?
Yeah, everybody out there.
Everybody?
Yeah.
The school?
Yeah. I mean, these guys get free condoms.
Tina, why are you telling us this?
For Katie. And maybe she wouldn't be so messed up if everybody wasn't laughing at her and her mother. Well, I've got homework.
Listen, Tina. It was very brave of you to come in here and tell all this to us. Can we get somebody to give you a ride home?
Or? Oh, no, thanks. You know, I'm not supposed to take rides from strangers.
Thank you.
Are you coming out?
No.
The front desk at the Bonaventure wouldn't tell me if Charles McMahon was staying there. A policy or something.
No, I expect not.
Looks like we have a story.
What story?
You weren't here?
Just because we now believe it doesn't mean that we get to go in the air and accuse the small town high school's best and brightest of a felony.
All right, so I'll simply go confront the police chief, the parents, the principal.
Well, what are they going to say? Oh, what was I thinking? Of course, that's it. This stuff about getting us major scholarship from the universities is all a cover.
Alex.
We've got more evidence now, Alex. We've got a statement from a teenage girl.
Who wants to remain anonymous?
Katie's mother.
Who looks insane and sounds insane and a victim who totally denies everything.
You know, you don't believe this girl was gang raped?
Yes, I know. I don't know.
Alex, there's something going on out there.
That we agree on.
That should be the story.
Well, the housekeeper showed she crawled under the fence.
Roger that. Hold on.
Hey, want to stop off at Louis? Drinks on me.
I'm late.
Come on, man. It's not even 8:30. You'd be perfect for Ramona.
Yeah, Unit 2, this is Alec.
Yeah.
Yeah, I need you guys to do me a favor.
Oh, come on, Alex. It's late. It's been a long day.
Hey, whatever you need, Alex.
Thanks, Tommy. I need you guys to go to the Bonaventure and confirm that a Charles McMahon is staying there.
Who? Who?
Top Gun from Channel 8's home office.
Alex, is this about them wanting Harry? Because if it is, you can let him go. We can do better. Don't wait until
tomorrow. Hey, you want to go to Louise for a pop?
I can't. I'm working on this high school rape story.
I thought there was no story.
What's it like?
What?
Being a high school...
jock?
No. Hero.
Okay, every college wants you. Every kid wants to be your friend. You can do no wrong.
Were you like this? No, I don't mean did you attack the girls or anything like that, but was getting somewhere with the girls the only thing on your mind?
Not the only thing.
You were the sensitive type. Okay, so what did they do with sensitive boys? Call them gay or whatever was used back then?
Fairy. It was fairy. No one called me that.
A videotape? That's perfect. I mean, how can they turn away a messenger with a tape?
Because you look like a bum.
Charles McMahon.
Hang. Come on in.
Right to the door. He came right to the door.
Shh. And he followed me all the way upstairs.
I told you we could con them. Well, give it a few minutes, then go back to my room and wait for Helen's call.
The beacon of truth.
Mitch, hi. How are you?
Is this Helen the Rude?
Yes, you're right. I was rude.
Call to laugh some more?
I apologize. I've been thinking about Harry, and, I can go 10%. Mm-hmm.
And with no injury, the tranquilized cat will have no after effects of his ordeal.
Other than a severe headache when he wakes up. Boy, I've been there. Sherry?
Turning to more serious news, Liz Vega has a special report for us tonight. Liz?
Hello.
story about a small town, about a high school, about an American tradition, about sex, and about a game that wasn't football. Yet it all came together here on this football field in the middle of another story, a positive story.
The mood here is optimistic. But then again, the mood is always optimistic because the Rockets have been state champions since 1984. 82. Well, who's going to argue with them?
But then a woman entered the picture claiming a teenage girl, her daughter, did try to argue with them and lost.
They raped my daughter! Four of them!
Could this be? Who was this woman, and how could she say such things about these boys?
And remarkably, every Rocket graduating has received a scholarship at a top university.
It was unthinkable that such bright, driven, competitive young men could be capable of such a crime.
They try to get as many girls as they can. It's a club to them. They just rack up points, and they don't care about the girl. What kind of a boy does this?
Could somebody make something like this up?
Of course she's making it up. These boys are the smartest, hardest working, most popular kids on campus.
Preposterous, ridiculous, outrageous, absurd, outlandish.
If there is something wrong with these fine boys, then there is something very wrong with America.
Rape is just the word these feminist ones use nowadays for intercourse.
What's a girl doing getting drunk, hanging all over half a dozen football players?
It's TV.
False, slanderous, prurient, silly. I've got more words than you've got tape.
My opinion? It was begging for it.
I mean, look over there. I don't know exactly who's tracking who, you know? But I'd have killed for girls like that when I was young, you know what I mean?
My son's only human, you know?
To tell you the truth, I'd worry if these boys weren't a little frisky.
Virginity? Most of these kids lose it before they can spell it.
I blame Wilt Chamberlain.
I met a virgin once. Used to have one.
You got blacks and Chicanos shooting each other all over, and you want to talk about the sex habits of some hard-working, motivated boys?
No. We don't supply the football team with condoms. That's a total distortion. We give condoms to everybody.
Does the truth emerge when all these comments are put together? Oh, it couldn't have happened here, and even if it did, boys will be boys, and girls just want to have fun. One truth is that with a climate like this, whether or not a victim steps forward, there is a victim. Innocence. You don't believe me? When we were taping the opening segment of this report, an interesting thing happened. This is what you saw. This is a story about a small town. But that was the second about take. A high school. Opening bit, take one. This is a story about a small town, about a high school, about an American tradition.
Yeah, honey, you'd be worth at least 12 points. Yeah!
If there is something wrong with these fine boys, then there is something very wrong with America.
This is Ms. Vega, Channel 3 Reaction News.
Bring it on!
Bloody sleepy time theater. Let's go.
No. Don't drop off, man.
You just sleep, ma'am, all right?
Shh. Let's go.
No. You, Tommy, you go to bed. You cannot spend the night at my place because I got company coming.
Let's go.
Well.
Oh, God, honey. You know, I am so sorry.
Tommy, just go to bed.
Yes, ma'am.
You know, the only reason that he was drunk is that we had to film this murder scene that was so horrifically gross that...
Save it, Eddie.
You know, he doesn't know what he wants.
Why does it seem like you're the only person who's trying to save this marriage?
Well, I guess, you know, his best man is part of the deal.
Maybe I married the wrong guy.
I gotta go.
It looks terrific.
I made Harry's head too big.
What? Really? I thought you were going with a race car driver.
I was.
You changed your mind.
I figured I'd make points if I did something no kid would ever do.
Oh.
See? Here's you. Here's Nancy.
Oh, looks like Nancy's having a little problem there.
I was afraid of that.
Something's up to it.
On Live Shot.
The beacon of truth isn't a bondage.
They stole my car.
Pardon?
My rental. They took it.
Who?
The smelly cameraman.
The Western Savings Tower continues to burn.
And all he wants to do is hang out with his gay lover, Eddie.
Santini Greer.
Where are you guys?
He wants to send Ricardo down here to anchor the 9 a.m. show.
What happened to your clothes?
UPN 20.